You guys ready for the best show ever?
Ever.
Welcome to Date Night with Connie and Chrissy. I'm your host, Connie Henriquez, and my crazy co-host, Chrissy Bogue.
What's up?
What up?
Happy Friday, everybody.
Happy Friday. What was up with that
snow? Happy snowstorm Friday.
Oh, my God. Anyone on Long Island? We had a crazy snowstorm this morning.
I know. They had the northern state was shut down for a while.
The Long Island Expressway on two exits, 49, I think, or something, right? 39, 40.
I didn't even leave my apartment.
I didn't either. Why would you?
You didn't leave.
Why would you?
I don't know. We had no idea what was going on.
I texted Chrissy this morning. I'm like, dude, are you at work? How'd you make out? She's like, now I'm home.
I'm like, well, the road's right now, and I would give you the traffic and weather update.
You gave me the update because I don't watch the news.
That's right. My dad watches it 24/7, so he gave me the update, and then I filtered it to you.
We could have relied on Brian.
BB.
Our weather.
That's right.
Our weather person.
He's better than Al Roker.
Who we love.
That's right. He called into our radio show on Tuesday.
He did. So actually, every Tuesday night, if you're on Eastern Long Island, you can catch us on 103.9. Yep. And if you are not, you can catch us on the internet at longislandnewsradio.com.
LINews.
That's right. And you can see us, but you can hear us Tuesday nights at 6 o'clock or sometimes 7, depending on the Islanders game.
They may see us soon, though, too, and hear us.
Well, yeah, we don't want to say anything.
Yeah, it might be a surprise.
Yeah.
We're
going to keep that as a surprise.
Right. We might
surprise you.
You might see us.
Right. You might see us. Twice in 1 week. Go figure.
Grab a jug of Tito's.
Right. So we had an amazing show this past week
where
we discussed what a guy looks for in a girl.
We had some callers, but...
We had some great callers. We had one guy who was super nice,
except
he had a very different spin on the whole thing. Do you
remember
what it was?
Yeah, the guy that was sick. He had some...
Well, apparently he worked...
Rheumatoid arthritis or something.
No, what about the guy that worked? He worked at a bar.
Oh, right.
And he had a lot of girls who came in who you know, like, projected them... Well, yeah. They acted like they were one way and they happened to be another.
Correct.
And so as a result, he became celibate for a number of...
That was very interesting, though.
It was. I don't think we knew what to say.
I know. And I said, is that the reason why you became that way? And he's like, no.
Right.
I'm like,
oh,
God.
We're like, oh, we don't
know. Well, that's what you were saying.
Right. We didn't know where to go with that.
I don't know. We asked people to call in regarding the topic, but they just went off topic.
We had to rely on David. He handled it
for us. Yeah, he handled it
very
well.
And the caller was very super great. Super great. But
we
didn't really know what to say to that.
Yeah. And then we had the awesome psychic Dawn Jolie?
I think it's Dawn Jolie. She called in.
I always wanted to meet her.
Right. But what did she tell you?
She's so nice.
Info.
She said, I'll meet my soulmate around Thanksgiving or Christmas.
Right. Now, when she said that, I was a little frightened because I'm like, oh, my God, Chrissy's going to have a heart attack. But you handled it really well.
No. Why would I have a heart attack?
Because you'd be like, that's all along.
Nah. It's already been long. Who cares at this point?
Ah, that's great.
Thank you.
Chrissy's coming along.
I'm learning to not give a crap anymore. Thanks to you.
I love it. So, yeah, so Long Island News Radio, we met with Mike, who's our new studio control guy. So we have a picture of Mike.
Mike Jets. He used to play for the New York Jets, my favorite
team.
He was a linebacker for, I think, about 3 years, and then he got injured.
Yeah, how amazing is that? Who knew?
Amazing. Mm-hmm. He had a Jets shirt on. He had his Jets jacket. I'm like, what?
It was
David was hiding it from us. He's like, I was going to surprise you. He used to play for the Jets. I'm like, now you tell me this?
He had you at Jets.
He had me at Jets. Yep, he did. He did. He had me at Jets shirt. And then when he said he played for the Jets,
Chrissy was all over it. Yeah.
Too bad it wasn't Eric Decker in the control room. Sorry, Mike. Maybe Eric will be there next week.
Maybe. That'd be a pleasant surprise.
We keep having somebody different every week.
I know.
It's a nice surprise.
It is.
But I love doing it. And shout out to David Levenstein. We love you.
Yes, we love you, David. You're awesome. And thank you to Nick. And who was the person before us that also did the studio control room for us?
Mike.
Another
I
Mike.
Loved Mike. He was my
Everyone's
my
really
love.
Super amazing over there. He was. Everyone's your love.
I know. And then Nick. I love all of them, actually. They're all great. And they're all
great.
In good relationships.
They all are amazing boyfriends, too.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
The things that they say that they do for their girlfriends. I'm like, where the hell were you guys when I was 20-something years old?
Right, which at such a young age. They're like 21, 22. At such a young age to know so much about relationships.
Right.
They're a keeper, ladies.
That's right. You better hold on to them, otherwise I'm going after them. All three of them. I'm going to see who wants me. I'll say. Aren't we supposed to be doing a dating night for me on Tuesday?
Yes. So
has David sent you any pictures yet?
Not yet. So on Tuesday, and I wish I had the number right at this moment, but you can call into the show. So I don't have the number for you right now, but check us out on Facebook at Date Night with Connie and Chrissy.
That's
and go to our Facebook page where we have
You could try out.
Exactly. You could try out to be Chrissy's blind date.
Jeff, I need you there to
Right. So you can try and call in, and prior to that you can try to submit your picture and bio to win a date with Chrissy Bogue on Long Island News Radio.
That's
date
right.
Night with Connie and Chrissy with Out of the Box with David Levinstein.
And why you'd be a great match for me.
Exactly.
Do you like the Jets? What do you like?
Do you love Tito's?
Tell us a little about
you. You're in.
That's right. Tito's and the Jets, you're in.
That's it.
Hands down.
And if you look like Eric Decker.
Well, that says, forget about it.
Forget
just
about it.
Just propose to me right there. Wait, what was the phrase that David kept saying?
What?
Pressure me and I'll just say yes or something about getting engaged.
Well, he was speaking about he loved the fact that girls would nag him.
Oh, right.
We thought that was a turnoff. As a girl, you never want to nag a guy.
Well, you thought it was. I don't.
I do.
I'm kind of on his side.
You're a nagger?
Not a nagger, but I'm like him.
You're
romantic.
You're up the guy's ass.
We're very loving.
No, nagging and
that's
being
not
romantic
said.
Is very different.
He just said, pressure me and I'll say yes.
Right.
I like his style.
A lot of guys get turned off by being pressured.
I know.
Right?
I know. I think he was saying it.
In a different way.
Yeah.
I don't think he really meant the way of nagging. Because
right.
that's annoying.
Right. I don't think he's a nagger.
I think it was more of he wants the girl to show an interest,
right.
a very strong interest, so he feels good about the relationship, and he interpreted that as nagging.
We should have him on the show.
We should. We will.
That's right. David, be looking out.
So, Bogue, because you are such a football fan, and
yeah.
I am clearly not.
Super Bowl Sunday.
Right. So what are you doing? Because we have a flyer for you.
Well, I hope you and Giuseppe are going to come meet me out at Piecraft in Island Park. DJ Chef will be DJing.
Nice.
As we're watching the game. And it's $50. Do we have it up? $50,
yep.
All you can eat and drink in Island Park. I hope you guys come.
$50, all you can eat and drink?
Yeah.
That's kind you of guys far, better, though. It's
freaking
far.
Oh, my
far.
God. But it's all you can eat and drink.
I know.
Did you not hear what I said?
I did. Well,
DJ
that's right.
DJ Chef's
yeah.
playing. It's going to be amazing. They have, what did it say on the floor? I don't know. They have
I
a
don't
bunch
remember.
Of.
I couldn't even see.
They have, like, how many flat screen TVs, Giuseppe?
Like a bunch.
I can't see
it's gone.
But there's a lot. There's a lot. It's in Island Park. Just come, guys.
And what time is it?
Well, the game starts at 6:30, but Chef is starting at 5.
Oh, perfect. And $50, all you can eat and drink.
That's right.
They have
so
Tito's?
We can have as much pizza. I don't know. I'm going to call them. You know what? I meant to call them.
Really?
I didn't want to sound like a weirdo, though. Hi, do you guys have Tito's?
It'll make the $50.
I do that,
so much
though. I call
it.
Places and ask. Do you guys have Tito's? Oh, no. All right. You won't be seeing me.
Now they're starting to get it. Now they, you know,
they're
used
on to
be
us.
Like, what happened to Goose and Kettle One? You're like, that's so old school.
We want the gluten free stuff. So come on. Get Tito's.
Exactly.
What are you guys doing?
We don't know yet. We were contemplating going there.
All right.
It's a little far, though. That's the only thing.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Just do it.
I know. Anyway, so I'm really excited about our guest tonight.
Me, too.
So her
I
name,
wish I could have went with you to the
I know,
workshop.
To the Crown Workshop. Exactly.
Yes.
So we have my very good friend, Janice Seminara.
Yeah.
And actually, I met Janice at years and years ago. We have a mutual psychic friend, Richard. And he used to do weekly meditation classes.
Ooh, I love that. Mm-hmm.
So Janice and I used to be in the same class.
Nice.
We hit it off because she was super cool. And as a result, she always had, well, and she was a writer. She's a whole bunch of things. I'll read you her bio in a second.
Yes.
But she's very cool. She's a very dear friend. And I'm super excited that she's here today.
She's very nice. She has her husband here, too.
Yes. And our husband, Frank, is here as well.
Maybe he could give us the man perspective.
The man perspective.
What's his name, Frank?
Frank!
We're going to bring Frank on, too.
So Janice is a certified integrative energy therapist, an educator,
that.
An artist, a writer, and a spiritual pioneer. So she's going to be on after the break. And
yeah.
We're going to talk a little bit more about what Janice does.
And you took the Crown workshop with
right,
her,
so what
which I didn't
Janice
get to go
does
to.
Is she does a Crown workshop, which we have one picture, Vic, if you want to pull it up. Yep, there we are.
I need one. I
it's
need to
with,
make one.
I went with my sister, Natalie.
Yeah,
and that is the crown that we made, and we had
beautiful.
Such a blast. It was so great. So
and
we're going to talk more
about
it.
You should wear yours when we come back.
I have it. I know.
I need one.
It
now I'm depressed. I don't have one.
You're going to, I know. Well, now you can go to the workshop.
All right.
I feel like you were at some Jets game or something. I don't know.
Probably. I could wear my crown to the next Jets game.
She'll wear it at every single
show
thereafter.
I'm going to make all green gemstones.
There you go.
For the Jets.
There you
I'm going to ask her what that means. Is that for money?
Maybe.
I hope
maybe.
So.
So, all right, so you ready for the Star Loving Life tip of the day?
Yeah, I almost forgot about that. Sorry.
All right, so this is in light of Janice coming on and speaking about what she does. But this is so key. Self-appreciation is self-love. What does that mean to you?
Oh, God. Why does she
I know, I don't want to
put you
on the spot.
I feel like I'm in class. I should love myself and appreciate myself.
Well, no, so many times people say, oh, self-love, self-love, but no one even knows what
that
means.
Well, no one knows how to do it.
Right.
I think nobody knows how to do that. What
exactly.
does that mean?
Exactly. So what
We're
that means
Janice.
Is self-love is self-appreciation, which means that you really focus on all the great qualities that you have.
Love and accept yourself.
Right. When you focus on the great qualities that you have, you then are in alignment with the love that you feel for yourself. And the worst thing is, which many people do, and we all do it, and we're all guilty of it, is that you're self-critical.
Very.
Right?
We
all
are.
You point out what your flaws are, or how you screwed up.
Right.
You know, so it's really difficult to really, like, feel good about yourself when you're focused on all the negative things.
True.
So you want to really make a point and focus on what you like about yourself. And it could be something, it could be anything.
What do you like about yourself?
I like my hair. I think I have really
great
hair.
You do have great hair. You should do hair commercials.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, the Dow Sassoon. Like, the commercials, I just saw, what's her name, Selena Gomez doing,
she's doing
that hair commercial. I feel like you can do that. Like,
really?
Whipping her hair around, the shiny, long
locks.
Yeah, I don't
know if I do that.
Congratulations, guys. I bleached the crap out of mine, so it's all
broken
off.
No, but you have beautiful hair.
No, congratulations.
You have beautiful
hair. What hair? It's gone. All right. I love that I got class clown.
Right, right.
I hate to bring it up again. But maybe some new viewers are watching today. And
they're unaware of your class clown award.
They're unaware of my biggest accomplishment my whole life, that I got class clown.
Right.
So thank you.
That is a perfect example of something that you appreciate about yourself because
you're
super funny.
Thank you so much.
Right.
I'd rather have long hair, but fine. I'll take it.
So just goes to show you. Just look for different characteristics that you have that you can appreciate. And again, it could be something as simple as your hair, which is kind of, you know, it's a physical attribute.
That's right.
Not that you want to focus on that, but that you're funny, that you're happy, that you're excited about life, that you look on the best side of things, or that you have a positive outlook.
Yeah.
You know, look for anything.
What would you do if Giuseppe shaved your hair off in the middle of the night?
I'd be like, thank God I'm dating Giuseppe because he loves me anyway. And he'd tell you he would never. And if so, he would buy me a wig.
That's right,
so
he would.
Fine.
He'd
like,
go
whatever.
Right out and get it the next day.
Right.
What a great guy. He went out to get my necklace in the unshoveled driveway.
Well, he knew when you asked the question, should I wear my necklace or should I not? Because it's in the car.
He's like, do you want me to go get it? if you want to. And then I couldn't explain where it was. He's like, I don't understand. Is it on the side door? I don't know, Jeff. Just look for it. You'll see it. Is it pearls? No. I'm not Connie. I don't wear pearls.
She's so demanding, this one over here.
Sorry, Giuseppe. Thank you.
So what's your bestie for the week?
Oh, my God. I forgot about myself.
I know.
All right. Well, it's very small. I think Vicky has
a picture. We love it.
All right. So, no, really. My sister got me this for Christmas. She's like, you and Connie are always posting selfies of yourself. So she bought me this. So now me and you can... you stick this on your iPhone. It's a selfie mirror.
Oh.
You can stick it on the iPhone or on the case.
Meaning on the back?
Yeah. And then what you do is turn it around and be like, oh, let me fix my lipstick. And then now we look selfie ready.
I love it.
And now we can take a selfie.
That's perfect.
I know. She gave it to me for Christmas. I'm like, oh, this is a great idea.
I think, was it more of a spoof gift? Like, oh my God, you guys take selfie all the time? Like, I want to.
Well, she was making fun of us. She's like, you guys are always...
I knew that
selfies.
Was the case, right.
But me and you, I always say to you, wait, hold on, let me lacquer up.
I know, I agree.
And I don't have a mirror to look in. Well,
I agree.
Now I do, guys.
But let me just say this, and this is what I never realized until someone told me. If you go to the camera feature and go to yourself, it's like a mirror.
Really? Really?
Yeah, if you go to the camera feature to the selfie, you see your face.
But you see it as good as like this?
Let me see.
Try it out. Live on
I mean,
TV.
This is clear, but... Yeah. You could do it with your camera. But anyway, we love it.
I love it.
We love it.
I'm going to stick it onto my iPhone today.
We shall no longer have bad selfie pictures because we clearly have a mirror now.
That's right. That's right. You can get it anywhere. I think she got it at Marshall's. She loves that store.
Oh, really?
She finds everything there. Huh. I don't find anything there.
I know.
I get anxiety as soon as I walk in. Yeah. Like, I don't know where to look. All right. So we'll be back with Janice. I can't wait.
Yeah. So
she's going to show us how to love ourselves.
That's right. So take a quick commercial, refill on your Tito's, and we'll see you in a few.
I got mine.
Being a fireman is more than just putting out blazes and giving kittens CPR. Sometimes my duty demands I fan the flames, like when a call comes in from a lady who needs immediate assistance.
Maybe she needs help with a computer thing. Maybe she wants to go antique. Could be as simple as understanding that walking in heels is, it's hard.
Aussi simple que l'été dernier à Paris. C'est sympa.
Maybe it's ladies' night in, and she wants a simple, delicious recipe for margaritas with a twist. First, a can of limeade. Now hold on to this, you'll be using it. Side note, kittens make everything better. Next, add water. Now, a bottle of light beer. It's not, shh, trust me, I'm a professional. And last, and most important, Sauza Blue Tequila. Now, mix it up. Ole. Yes, that's what I'm trained for. Whether it's to help her choose leggings or pants, telling her leggings are pants, or discussing leggings and jeggings versus pant pegging at her next ladies' night in, I'll come to the rescue. Don't call me a hero. Just call me. Let me know what time.
Tom Mealy from Madhouse TV, and when I'm not at the studio, I'm here at the Harrison Law Group. This is my real job. In this January 2015, Brett and I are putting together a show called Legal Straight Talk. It'll be aired on Cablevision as well as here at Madhouse TV. You need to tune in. This information that we're going to be giving the public is the real deal. It's all about what you should do, what you shouldn't do. So tune in this January 2015 for a new episode of Legal Straight Talk.
We're back! Yay!
Yes!
We have Janice Seminara with us today. We're very excited. Our crown woman.
Do you go by that? Is that your nickname?
Crown lady.
Crown lady.
An integrative energy therapist.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yes.
I need it. All those. Everything you offer, I need it.
That's right. Janice is definitely it. So, Janice.
Yes. Yeah.
Question for you, okay? This is going to be the first one. I know you're all about divine feminine, right?
Yeah.
So for a lot of our audience, they're not really familiar with what that term means. So can you tell us a little bit more about that?
Sure. The divine feminine is the sacred female and actually goes back to the first matriarchal society, which is what the world was. And it was a matriarchal-driven society. And that's not to say that the females were in a higher power than the males were, okay. But it was an equal society,
mm-hmm. Ooh,
where
okay.
The balance of male-female energy, which all of us have, we each yeah. have male-female energy, was
I have a lot of male energy.
Beautiful and intact, and then somehow that got buried and became a patriarchal society. The divine feminine is the compassion, the love, the kind of nurturing, healing qualities that women own. That's a woman's power.
And you help people to hone into that and develop that more?
Remind them of it. It's just the crown is just a remembrance of that feeling. You know, when you were a little girl and
right.
you had your little crown And then we get to wear a crown again when we have our communion, if we make our communion. And then you get to wear a crown again at your prom. Mm-hmm. And then maybe you wear a tiara when you get married. Yeah. All those special events. And then from then on, you don't get to wear a crown anymore. Mm-hmm. It's that special feeling that little girls even have. And it comes through play and acting out on your divine feminine, which is owning your power and being sacred to yourself and to yourself.
Now, Janice, you had this cute story about your daughter and the reason, and one of the inspirations in terms of why you do what you do now.
Yeah.
So can you just share it quickly? Because I think it's a great story.
Well, the first one was when she was in second grade. It was her birthday, and all little girls want Barbie dolls. And mm-hmm. I had to bring a cake to school, so I dressed Barbie up like a princess and stuck her in a castle cake. Mm-hmm. And she had a crown, and there was a story with it about the birthday princess that lit a candle in the sky every night for anyone whose birthday was that day, because you're special and loved, and everybody loved it. Mm-hmm. And then fast forward to her sweet 16, and she had the tiara, and she had the tiara for 2 weeks. And every time I came downstairs, she was watching cooking shows wearing a tiara.
I love
and
it.
I said, why are you wearing that all the time? And she said, because, I don't know, it makes me feel good. Aww. So I sort of became obsessed with crowns. And Connie knows, she came to my first crown workshop, which was paper.
No way.
Yeah. We made paper crowns.
Why? I totally forgot about that.
In the yoga studio ages ago.
Oh, my God.
Remember? And we wrote on the back of the crowns what we loved about ourselves,
things we wanted
to improve, and then we put the little paper crown on.
And
it's evolved.
Yeah, one thing I want to say, though, it's just so great. Chrissy and I see a lot of this. We have had friends that we've had for years. Mm-hmm. And it's so interesting because we all want to do our own thing. And we all have different paths that we want to take. And it's so nice that we all grow together. Yeah. And so perfect example is, you're right, like the paper crown from years ago. And you were speaking of these workshops that you've always wanted to do. And now that you're doing it, it's just so amazing. And we see a lot of that.
It's amazing.
I want to go to it.
Well, I have a surprise for you.
Oh my God! Is it a bear claw like Tom Haley gave to me once?
No.
Oh, thank you. This is beautiful.
And this is for Connie.
Oh,
oh my God, they're pink.
Yeah, they're pink.
Oh my God, Janice, thank you.
The little card will tell you, which is what I do when you're not making a crown and you buy one. I put the stones on the back. So yours is rose quartz.
Oh my God. This is absolutely gorgeous.
Put it on.
Are you kidding me right
now,
Janice?
It's a love crown.
Oh my God. I love you.
Oh, that's beautiful.
That is perfect. Janice, I love you. This is beautiful.
I love it.
Don't you feel nice?
I really do. I really feel happier. I'm not kidding.
And does yours fit, sweetie?
It fits perfect.
Oh, my God.
I
she loves those type of bracelets.
I do.
That fits right in.
I really do.
So when we use these crystals or we put these on, or do you send energy to them? Like, how does it work? Are they filled with energy? What is the meaning behind it?
Well, the crystals all have energy. They're from the earth. And each different type of crystal has a different type of energy. Rose quartz is the love stone.
Aww.
It carries
love. So, like, my soulmate with this?
Self-love. It will help you to honor and love yourself. And when that is all intact, that person's just going to show up.
Now,
Janice, should we
encourage Chrissy to wear this at the bar? Because I'd be a little
scared.
Yeah,
should I wear this out? Like on the Super Bowl?
I wear mine everywhere I go.
But
I have different crowns.
It looks normal on her.
This is my Disney crown.
Let me see. Oh, my God. I love that.
When I write, I used to wear this because it brought my mindset up to my higher self.
Mm-hmm. I love this.
And plus, I was honoring myself by giving myself the time to do the thing that I love the most, which is writing. And then it evolved.
How did you get started into this? Like, what made you start wanting to make the crowns? And
Well, actually, when my friend got her PhD, she invited me to her party. And we had a very dear friend who passed away this summer, Judy.
Oh, I'm
and
sorry.
Everybody loved Judy. She used to work for NBC. Everybody loved Judy. And she had a party in honor of Judy. It was called the Judy Party.
Oh.
So I made everyone a crown because I always saw Judy as like the queen to me. And this was my first crude crown.
Oh,
and then I had written in wire what I, because I'm an intuitive as well, what I intuited about that person.
Wow.
So it either said writer or lover
really?
Or pain in the ass, you know. But
No way, really?
Yes.
I love that.
And then the wire came off, but this was mine.
Mm-hmm. Do you make those still with the names of what you think of people?
I actually had a friend of mine who's a chakra healer, very excellent healer.
Oh, good.
And,
we want that.
Oh, and she's awesome.
I always wanted to find one of those.
Oh, well, we'll have
now,
to
Janice,
give you her
just
card.
Explain quickly for people who don't know what chakras are.
Okay, so there are energy centers in your body, and they're called chakras. Mm-hmm. Yogis and spiritual people know mm-hmm. about the energy centers. And there's a root chakra, then there's sacral chakra. Mm-hmm. This, your solar plexus, is your power chakra.
Okay.
Heart chakra, throat chakra, third eye chakra, and this is your crown chakra.
Okay.
Your crown chakra is the gateway to the divine. So this is part of when I became an integrated energy therapist, which is energy channeling through the angels, I would meditate and see myself making crowns all of a sudden again.
Wow.
So I made a crown for every person in my integrative energy class.
No. Wow.
And this was it.
Wow.
I love that one.
God.
I think
that
one's so beautiful.
This is my original. But see, this has the clips.
Right.
So when you come to a workshop, you have an option of a crown.
Okay.
Or this, because I think you have to wear it all the time.
I love it. Can you wear it to bed?
Well, I don't know about that.
You can, Chrissy. You can.
You
can. Do you wear yours every day?
I almost do, yes.
Okay.
And I have different ones for different occasions. This is my big Archangel Michael crown.
Oh, I love Archangel Michael.
And this has a big lapis lazuli, which, about the crystals, lapis is the stone of the goddess.
Nice.
And the clear quartz crystals, mm-hmm. which are on yours as well,
okay.
clear quartz crystals amplify all the other stones. And this has a stone called blue kyanite, which is like an angelic.
Now, Janice, how did you learn about all these stones? Like,
yeah.
It seems like you know what each one means. Like,
after I had that vision of making the crowns, I just started to learn about them mm-hmm. and read about them, because I'm very into auras and color, too.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, the colors that you're wearing mm-hmm. are self-love. That's what pink
is.
Yeah,
that's why we wear pink on date night.
Yes.
Can you read our aura, or do you see our aura, or we're just pink?
I don't know.
We just pink
I could intuit, but really beautiful and joyous. When I look at you, Connie, I know for so, a long time, and she is really the epitome of the type of person that has learned how to mm-hmm. love herself mm-hmm. and be positive. Because she simply honors herself to the point where she has a talk show now.
Yep. Aww,
I mean, that's what it's all
buddy.
About.
She is like that, yep.
Yep, and that I've honored sense. Myself to do this.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and people say, you make crowns? But I do.
Well, they're trying to make fun of it. I don't like you guys then.
No.
When you wear it, though, what is the symbol behind wearing the crown? Is it supposed to just make, what is the meaning behind wearing the crown?
The meaning behind wearing a crown is honoring yourself the way you would as a child when you go back
okay.
and you decide when you're playing and you're the queen and you put that crown on your head and you start strutting around and being special.
Okay,
but the thing is, the power, that it got corrupted, because it's not about being overpowering the male. Especially today, the female divine mm. is coming back because we need that balance. Mm-hmm. And females have that healing energy. It's our sacred right. to say, I'm a female and I love it. That's you guys are girly girls.
Yeah.
When I was younger, you know, like a long time ago,
no,
I was into
like
flowing dresses and long hair, and that's just who I am. And
right.
I still honor that. But I had stopped for a while because in order to be equal, mm-hmm. we were being encouraged to dress like men in the workplace.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, to have that equal job and equal pay. But it's not about, balance is not about equality in that way.
Right.
It's about the energy and bringing the world back into the way it should be so it could flourish and people will love each other.
I never get that. Let men be men, okay? They're men.
Right.
We love men. Like, let them be men. Seriously, I don't get the whole equality.
And this
oh
is
my
getting
God.
Like the women back to being that playful, happy self back when they were.
It's
young.
A reminder. You put that on every day, mm-hmm. and after a while, you won't even have to wear it.
Mm-hmm.
I found a little sparkly sign. I'm going to send you one.
Yay,
and it says, wear your invisible crown.
Oh, I love that.
Yes. And Marianne Williamson wrote a beautiful book.
I love Marianne Williamson.
A Woman's Worth. Did you read it?
No.
I brought it with me. It's fabulous.
There you go.
When we come back from a commercial, we'll put it up here on the coffee table.
Right.
We'll throw some crap off.
Right,
and put
exactly.
It up there.
But I think to Janice's point, there are so many times that you don't give yourself credit. So that having a crown on your head is making you more
a reminder
of your life, where you're in charge.
Right.
You create your own reality. You appreciate the wonderful qualities that you have. And it just, you know, it's like that reminder.
That's a very good point, being grateful every day for the little miracles that happen in your life. This is a miracle.
Aww.
I started this in April. If someone would have said to me, you're going to be talking about this on an online television
show. On date night. Come on.
She needs a Tito. Somebody, Joseph. Janice needs a Tito ASAP.
All right, guys, so we're going to be back with Janice after this quick commercial break.
I love my crown.
Janice,
I know,
it's beautiful.
Thank you so much.
Well,
that was really kind of you that you did.
A Toyota. But when you want more from your Toyota store, you want Smithtown Toyota, where every Toyota comes with Smithtown Toyota's Toyota for Life program, giving you lifetime New York State inspections, lifetime 10% discounts on all parts and service, 2 years of complimentary oil changes, 2 years of scheduled maintenance, and more, all at no cost to you. Plus, low clear-out deals on every Toyota in stock. Get more from your Toyota store. Hurry to Smithtown Toyota.
Welcome to Formula Auto Wash, where every day is a great day for a car wash. Open 7 days a week from 8 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. Sundays, 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. Detailing packages for every budget, starting out at $29.99. 100% hand wash and detail center. Hogs hair and microfiber brushes and mitts. Proudly using Ecolab Blue Coral soaps and waxes. Formula Auto Wash has served the community for over 30 years. Senior discounts all day, every day. Ladies Day Wednesday, $3 off any wash. Early bird discount Monday through Thursday till 9:30 a.m. Check out our website, formulaautowash.com.
We're back with the fabulous Janice Seminara, integrative energy therapist, writer, author, and everything else you can think of under the sun. Janice.
An amazing crown maker. Look, she gave me a new crown already.
I know, I love it.
What is this one for again, Janice?
That's Archangel Michael protection.
Oh, I need it.
You do need that.
And the big stone in the middle is the goddess stone of lapis lazuli.
What's that?
Blue is also the color of communication, by the way.
Oh, I don't think she needs any help in that department. She's pretty communicative.
I like the bling on the side, that really pretty stone.
Well, the bling is important.
I need the bling. We need it on date night.
I bring Austrian crystals when I do my workshop.
You do?
So you could choose whatever stone you want. You go through a meditation, and the meditation sort of tells you what you need.
Really quick, before I was going to get into the other stuff I want to talk to you about, with the crown, now you say it comes with a prayer to the angels, and then the other one is a poem?
It's a beautiful poem. that just speaks about a woman, and there's a couple of lines in it about a crown, about losing your stones.
Okay.
It's just losing your stones is a metaphor for giving away our power. And when do we give away our power? When we're afraid or if someone doesn't like us.
I like that. Mm-hmm. And you said you pick an affirmation. So you pick an affirmation when you make your crown.
Yes, you decide, like the crown that I'm wearing today, this when I made this crown, it's this called the sun-moon crown because it has sunstones and moonstones on it.
It's beautiful.
Sunstones and moonstones are male-female energy. So this is my balance crown.
That's nice.
My all-around balance crown.
I love it.
Now, when somebody comes to these workshops, I know you do the crown making, but how do you teach somebody who's struggling with self-love, confidence? How do you teach that?
Well, again, we go through the chakras because I have a meditation that I was inspired to create.
Okay.
And through the meditation, there may be certain colors or symbols that someone sees. And also because I'm intuitive, I'll talk to them and see kind of what wavelength they're on.
Okay.
And that meditation informs the person who's making the crown what color stones they should choose. Mm. And many times girls will come in and say, I just want a pink crown and I'm just using pink stones. And then they go through the meditation and they say, well, now I'm making a blue crown.
No, I'm guilty of that. I did that. Yes, because I love pink.
Me too. That's my favorite color.
So I went
color.
In there thinking I was going to make a pink crown.
Mm-hmm.
And my crown ended up being like purpley.
Why aren't you wearing your crown? Put it on. It's beautiful.
I know.
Yes, see how sparkly
it is. Put it on.
Isn't it beautiful?
It is beautiful.
And so
what does that mean that she was more drawn to the purple stones?
Well, I don't remember what her meditation was, but purple stones are higher crown chakra, mm-hmm. a third eye, and also purple is a soothing color. Mm. It's also the color of someone coming into their intuition.
Yeah, my intuition.
Put it on, man. What are you doing?
You
don't want to mess up your weave?
Oh, and you know what? Something very exciting that I just started doing is I'm doing bridal parties.
Oh. No way!
Yeah. So I'll make the bridal queen if they want it. And the girls will make their headpieces for the wedding.
Oh, that's a great idea.
I love that idea.
It's going to be fun.
You haven't started it yet?
I just got my first booking the other day, so I'm excited.
That's amazing.
And they'll wear it out when they go out at night.
Yeah, they'll wear it for one girl's going to wear it for the shower, then another is going to be actually letting her bridesmaids wear those headpieces for their wedding.
That was a great idea. So when she gets married, I hope I get to wear a crown at your bachelorette party.
Bachelorette party?
Yeah, I'm going to wear this. Actually, I don't even need one. I have my beautiful crown right here.
That's beautiful.
A great idea. Oh, wait. Let's not forget about this.
Oh, this is adorable.
My sister has a chihuahua. I have to make one for Grace. This is beautiful,
by the way. I love it.
Janice makes crowns for dogs. You have a little dog.
Oh, actually, I didn't make that one. Oh.
What about
But that's
make,
a good idea.
Can you make
Who's this
a,
for?
I have a king. I have a male dog. Do you have anything for that?
I could make a crown for
any
dog.
You can make a little
dog,
crown for
but
him.
That's Stella Luna, my little pug's crown.
Aww,
I think it's adorable.
This is beautiful. Does she really wear it?
Well, she put it on for her birthday last
no.
week.
No.
Yes,
this
she did.
Awesome.
Ask my husband.
Oh, my God.
Frank, is that true? Did she wear a crown? Did you think it was crazy
Frank.
Or did you love it? Oh, what a great
this is
guy.
He lives with me.
Hey, you know what? You should do a whole class with making a crown for dogs. I swear to God, I bet you'll book up quick.
That'll
How many
book
people,
up
I swear to God,
they,
more than the bachelorette
exactly.
party. More than the bachelorette right. party,
they
right?
They treat their dogs better than themselves.
Sadly, yes. Mm-hmm. And that's what the whole thing is about. You know, you want to... And I keep in touch with my girls when they come to the workshops. One of them told me that she kept it by her bedside, and it just helped her because she used to be a tomboy.
Oh.
So just bringing back that little bit of femininity.
Mm-hmm.
It's all about the femininity.
I love it. I love
it. So when you're teaching the courses or doing the workshops, are you also adding in affirmations or
yes.
Words of encouragement?
Well, one thing, and just so to speak from experience, when I was at the workshop, mm-hmm. she did open it up with a meditation, which I thought was great.
And then
from there, she said, jot down all the words that you remember from your meditation.
Mm.
So from there is when you determine the color of the crown, and hence why I don't know how I got it, but I decided to do purples and blues
right.
versus the pink, which I love.
Yeah, I would have went
yeah,
all pink.
Yeah, and I
right?
have a little list. It's just not comprehensive. Most of the stones I have.
Okay.
So when you're leaving, I'll look at your crown and check off what you have. And it tells a story. Mm-hmm. And then people start reading about it and they're like, wow, yeah, I really did need that. You know, maybe your heart chakra needs a little bit zhuzh, you know. So
right.
The heart chakra, the color of the heart chakra is green, really.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh, I didn't know that. Maybe, Vogue, you were just talking about green before.
I know, that's weird.
I'm going to make you a Jets crown.
Oh, my God. I love you, Jess. I really love you. I love you so much. That's
you're,
very
you're
nice.
Getting
Thank
one.
You. I love her. I love her. Maybe she's
too
my soulmate.
I hope the Jets
Maybe
win.
Jess is my soulmate. I know. I will wear that to every Jets game if you really make it for me. Really
oh, my it. God. I'll have it for you by Sunday.
All right. I can't wait for next season. I'm going to wear it every
yeah,
Jets
Yeah, you have
game.
Until next year. Don't worry, Janice. No rush.
So when they're leaving with the crown, you give them like a little reading, like what stones they picked.
Right.
And then they get like a little reading.
A real mini one. I hand out a little card. They pick out a card from a pile and I'll do a real quickie.
An angel card reading?
I do one-on-one personal crown workshops, which is an extensive reading that I do with this big, a grid that I created. So as you're making your crown, I'm talking to you.
Oh, I love that. I want to do that. Let's do that. We could film it. Have Giuseppe film it.
There's nothing else to do over there. All
right, for Zank, we'll get Frank.
Right, so during the crown workshop, Janice will go to each individual person and she'll pull out an angel card.
I love that. See, we're both into that. I love that. Mm-hmm.
And I do the angel bracelet workshop, which is another workshop.
How would I have?
Oh, wait, I didn't see that. I want
the archangel.
Oh, that's an angel?
Is this an angel? It's a
well, that one
bracelet.
I just made for
It's a love bracelet.
It's a love bracelet. But this is Archangel Uriel because it's yellow. That's the Archangel
that's
of Light. So we
have
an
angel workshop.
I use a book by Kyle Gray, who's called The Angel Whisperer in Scotland. Young man.
Oh, my God, Scotland. I'm Scottish. I
oh, my God.
Kyle Gray is awesome.
I've been to Scotland. They're the nice people in the world.
You're Scottish?
Yeah. My last name is Scottish. I'm not all
is
Scottish.
It?
Yeah.
You have to buy Kyle's book.
I'm going
to
get it.
Angel Prayers.
So he's amazing at that.
He's amazing. He does readings from the UK.
We should Skype him. We're going to Skype him and have you on at the same time. This is great. I can't wait. So, all right. So you do the angel readings. Oh, wait. What's the magic wand workshop?
Okay. So that's a new one that's coming up.
Yeah. Let's tell everybody about that.
I use a selenite wand. Selenite is a crystal that's good for clearing energy. You never have to clear a selenite.
Okay.
Other stones you clear by putting them in the sunlight, but selenite you never have to clear.
Okay.
And we put crystals on it. Same thing. I bring you through a meditation.
Okay.
And the meditation will inform you what crystals you need to put on your wand. And then that's geared toward manifestation.
I love that. I want to go to that workshop. When is that
Which
coming
all
up?
Comes from where?
Yourself. Love.
Bingo, Connie. Bingo.
There you go.
But the wand is a representation to just remind the person that it comes from within.
They're sacred tools, exactly. Right. Sacred tools. That's why I call it divining designs, because you're going within, actually, and divining the tools that you need to move forward with your
And
life.
It's a nice reminder. You could put it on your nightstand reminder.
That's a reminder.
I create my own life.
Right.
I have this beautiful
reality. Right.
Crystal magic wand. It's just a reminder for people to realize.
You pick it up. You do this every day.
Like Harry Potter type thing.
Yep.
I love it.
So when is that workshop? Because we want to go to that one.
Well, I've been doing workshops at the Long Island Center for Long Island Healing Arts Center and Learning in Huntington on Jericho Turnpike. Mm-hmm. And I'll be doing the Angel Bracelet workshops in February.
Okay.
And the Magic Wand workshop is slated for March.
Okay.
So it's going to be a debut.
Give us your website so that way people can look up the specifics and of where.
Okay. It's www.goddessesinthegarden.com. Goddesses, plural.
I love that name. Mm-hmm. And you did a workshop last night, you said, on self-love, right?
Self-love. We had a Valentine's Day workshop
at
the Huntington Healing Arts Center. Mm-hmm. And again, you know, we talked about self-love, and a young girl came with her mother. I just love the mother-daughter crown workshops. Because women our age, you know, we need to reinvent ourselves,
mm-hmm.
too.
Mm-hmm.
And by the time you are my age, some of us have been through a lot.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to remind yourself of that little girl again, that divine, happy, joyous little child, where you would wake up in the morning and only look forward to happy things.
Mm-hmm.
We could still do that. We're supposed to do that. That's what we were born to do.
And that's what you're teaching them in this workshop.
I hope so. You know, I do. I just also, I don't even know if you know, Connie, I became a columnist for OverTheMoonMag.com.
Yes, I've read your article. It's amazing.
It's a fabulous magazine about the feminine divine, and every month I'm going to be writing an article about a different goddess and, you know, how she relates contemporarily. So my first goddess was Artemis, who's goddess of the hunt, torchbearer, but also Artemis was born with a twin, and I'm a twin.
I have a brother. I did not know you were a twin.
Yeah,
my
nephews
are twins.
So when I read the article, I was very, I was like, oh, crap, I didn't know Janice was a twin.
Yeah. Are you fraternal or identical?
Fraternal.
Oh, that's my nephews, too. Aww.
Yeah. So we all have goddess archetypes in us. I could tell you, you are very Aphrodite.
Me?
Yes.
So what does that mean?
She's very Athena.
So wait, tell us what that means.
Aphrodite is the goddess of love and beauty. But not just the cosmetic goddess that all these young girls are trying to be. Compassion and love and beauty of all things. And your comedy is hysterical. It's a beautiful thing.
Thank you.
And Connie is just, you know, a goddess of, I see a lot of Athena and Connie, the crafter also. You're almost like a warrior woman, you know, you do, a warrior of teaching people how to enjoy life.
Mm-hmm. That is her.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
She pegged us, man.
Love it.
Did you bring angel cards? I want an angel reading now.
No,
I love this.
I
could do this all night. I could do this. Wait, we have another break?
Yeah,
I can keep going with Janice.
All right, guys, so we're going to be back with our very amazing Janice.
And our beautiful crowns.
Minutes, so,
wait,
we
got to make Jeff one.
I know.
Well,
Jeff
stand.
Already has one. He doesn't need a crown.
Where is it? Invisible crown? We'll be back.
I think this is a good time to tell you. You're doing okay, Mom. I can call you Mom, right? I know we haven't known each other very long, but you seem like a real keeper. You're not perfect. There was that strained carrots incident, but you're trying. You pick up my bottle every time I toss it out of my stroller. That's high comedy to an 8-month-old. You hum the Barber of Seville when you wash my hair. So cool. And your rubdowns are out of this world. Anyway, I want you to know how much I appreciate you. You know, right? How much I love you? You're doing okay, Mom.
What are you looking for? You don't even know that. You're on the ball, so you can't even answer. I'm asking you about it.
You gotta be highly skilled.
You understand that? Are you well versed there? You very smart man. Hit me with some funny shit.
My shit's twisted.
Tell me some.
What do you have right there?
That's awesome.
Well,
that's a big.
It's nice.
That's awesome.
Sir.
Are you interested in
twisted talent?
Yeah,
man.
I'm sure. You see what I'm saying? You understand me? And if you can't whip out answers like that, that man is liable to go on a commercial break, punch your fucking mouth loose. You understand me? Time is up, sir. You understand me? You're on. You're the man. All right, give me your name now. I'm sorry.
My name is Willie.
Willie, where are you working at?
We are twisted. We are awesome. Love awesome.
Can you repeat that question again?
And we're back with Janice Seminara, our awesome intuitive crown lady.
That's right. Talking about how I'm Aphrodite and you're just Athena.
I'm just Athena.
I'm just kidding. I'm the compassionate one. But we always knew that.
Yeah, we always knew that.
All right, so go ahead. What were we going to ask her?
We were going to talk about her upcoming. So, Janice.
No. Go ahead.
Wait, so what?
No, go ahead. I already forgot. I don't even know. I thought we were talking about loving ourselves. Good.
We were. All right. So, Janice, give us some tools for people that are watching at home that maybe are not on Long Island and they can't get to your workshop. What is something they could do at home to really you know, create their own crown and find their own divine femininity?
Okay, that's a really good question.
Go to one of her workshops.
Yeah, but if they're not on Long Island.
I'd like to do a webinar. Ooh, I'm just trying. I need a little bit more time. But I actually post a lot of my crowns on Facebook, and a woman from another country said that I inspired her to make her own crown.
Oh my
God. And she was so happy. And she said, I hope you didn't mind. I said, why would I mind? You know, she went and bought the materials, which is something I want to do, too, is I'd love to make up a little kit and so you could do that.
Oh, that's
and it's just
idea.
You have a little ceremony and simply celebrate yourself. It's as simple as that.
Right, you can make a pouch with all the crystals and sell it on your website.
And as you're, it's a process. I married my educational training with my spiritual development. And I came up with a process where when you're doing something for yourself, I mean, mm-hmm. I could make you a crown and I could make you a crown.
Right.
But when you're making it yourself, it's you're thinking about what you're doing.
Uh-huh,
you've
that's true.
Got yourself to the place.
Right.
You paid whatever you paid to be there. And now you're sitting there learning how to do something you've never done before.
Right.
You know, most of them come in and say, I don't know how to do this. And they walk out with beautiful crowns.
It's true. That's what I was. I don't know how to do this.
Yeah, but you're crafty.
Yeah, but she explained how to do the wire. I kept running out of wire.
And that process it helps affirm why you're there to begin with. Even if it's not on a conscious level, you're honoring yourself.
Mm-hmm.
So every time you put that crown on your head, you're honoring yourself.
Oh, I love
you just
that.
Are.
Mm-hmm. And with the magic wand, too, you were saying that represents manifestation.
Yes, and so you would affirm, you would say an affirmation. And my affirmations I like to use are usually prayers to different archangels. And I will thank, Archangel Shamuel, who's the Archangel of the Heart, for opening my heart and letting me learn this craft to help others learn how to open theirs.
What if somebody's looking for love, since Valentine's Day is coming up next week?
I would tell them to look within.
Oh.
I would.
Can you be more specific for people that don't understand that?
Look for the things that are inside of yourself that you love about yourself.
Mm.
Like I heard you ask before what she loved about herself.
Uh-huh.
And vice versa.
Yeah.
I think that's fabulous.
Mm-hmm.
And but it's sadly some people can't find that one, little thing.
She's right.
They don't even realize the package that they are.
Mm-hmm.
We all are.
Right.
All of us women. And women have been suppressed out of society. You know, God, women can't even breastfeed. It's a big deal.
I know.
I mean, so those little pushes here and there, you're a woman, you can't do this. You're a woman, you can't do that.
Right.
That makes you feel less than, but you are that and more. You're all that.
Mm.
And when you start to honor yourself and you practice it, and you might want to do a little meditation every morning and just say that, I am love. I am peace, or whatever it is that you want to be.
Mm-hmm.
I am funny.
So, Janice, Valentine's Day is Sunday, and we have a lot of peeps out there.
Next Sunday.
Oh, it's next Sunday?
Yeah.
Oh, Sunday's
the Super Bowl.
Oh,
how
man.
Can you
forget?
Go Broncos.
All right, so you got another week to find a boyfriend if you don't want to be.
Good.
So, Janice, for those people that are single on Valentine's Day, what do you suggest some things that they can do for themselves instead of being at home upset perhaps
like
that they're single?
Or worrying about a box of candy that...
Correct, or something.
I know what I'm going to be doing.
What?
Wearing my crown.
Good girl!
I am.
Eating a box of chocolate.
I am. I'm going to be with Connie and Joseph. I'm going to be the third wheel. Maybe I'll wear
You're
this crown instead.
And you could borrow that
one. Should I wear the dog one?
Oh, you can hang out a pumpkin.
And Grace, my sister's dog. God, I'm sorry, Janice.
Well, it's sad. You know, people sit around Valentine's Day, like you said, and I don't
such
know.
Such an overrated holiday.
Instead of sitting there complaining about not having, do something about it.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe go somewhere. Go visit your grandmother who's all alone all these years.
Mm.
Do something that comes from
makes
your
you feel
heart.
Good.
Because the heart, it will inform, the rest of your soul. So if you're going to sit and lament about Valentine's Day, why don't you be proactive? And before Valentine's Day comes, plan something that you love to do. Maybe you're a beach person.
Okay.
Right.
Maybe you want to do some stand-up comedy somewhere.
All right.
Plan
I
it
like
ahead.
Jazz.
that on Valentine's Day, you're going to do something that shows you that you love yourself.
And you know what? I have a great idea for people that are local on Long Island. What? There's this amazing meetup that's happening on Sunday, Day.
On Valentine's Day, next
Sunday.
2 to 4,
and it's our meetup, date night with Ray and Chrissy, attract a soulmate.
We should have her come make crowns.
There you go. And it's going to be on Sunday, 2 to 4, in Patchogue.
And so you could go sign up at longislandmeetup.com.
Meetup.com, date night with Connie and Chrissy.
Look for date night with Connie and Chrissy. Please sign up.
I'm going to tell about that.
Yes.
It's going to be amazing.
And maybe we'll do another one with her. We'll do like a crown making one with her incorporated with the date night.
There
that
you
would
go.
Be amazing. That would be fun. Would you do that, Janice?
So make sure.
Yes. Because we love you.
I think you're great. Thank you.
You're such a nice person.
Oh.
You have such like a calm presence.
She does.
Wish I was calm like that.
What do you mean? You are calm. All right, dude. So grab
your
selfie.
You just told me before I wasn't.
Well,
wait, we're done already? Wait, we got 5 minutes.
Oh, so Janice, just quickly, tell us where everyone could find you again.
At www.goddessesinthegarden.com.
And your next workshop is?
2 weeks from now.
Not Valentine's
Day. Not Valentine's Day, the Saturday after. I'm doing an Archangel bracelet workshop at the Huntington Healing Arts Center.
And they can sign up on your website?
They can sign up on my website or at the Long Island Healing Arts Center website.
Okay.
Or you can call them. And they also sell a lot of my crowns.
They do?
Yes. Oh, yeah.
No way.
I love it.
And you're doing the magic wand one when, do you know?
In March.
Perfect. I'm going to be at that one.
All right, guys. So check out Janice's website, Goddesses in the Garden.
Crown Lady.
Crown
I love
lady.
Mine. I can't wait to get my Jets one for next season. I'm going to wear it every
No, I'm going to have that for your next game.
Oh, my God. I love
it. I have
her.
A week.
And then Janice.
What a nice
No, you have a whole year. They don't play until next season. Come on. That's like next year.
No, isn't the
it's
Jets
not
the
year.
Super Bowl next week? Oh, the Jets didn't get
Jets.
In.
The Jets
are
out. Yeah. Janice.
They're out. You have until like August.
We haven't been in a long
time. So, Janice, also on Facebook, where can people find you?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, at Janice Seminara, my author page. Or Goddesses in the Garden.
Oh, wait. What books did you write? Wait, we didn't talk about her books. We have a minute. What books did you write?
I'm writing a book about my workshops.
Oh.
And how it evolved into the life that I'm leading now.
Yeah.
Is that the only book that you have, or you have another one?
I wrote a play, if anyone's
interested.
Nice. About goddesses.
Can we be the actors in it?
Yeah.
Of course we can.
All right, we'll take a selfie.
All right, we're
it's selfie time.
Selfie. So we can end our show. Janice, this is what we do at the end of every single show.
Okay, so I have to pick up that little thing.
Yeah, just watch a mic so you don't
hold your mic
it.
Behind you.
Okay.
Giseph will be taking pictures as well.
Mm. Oh, how cute.
That's a cool device.
Do you love it?
Yeah.
We're like selfie pros over
here. Is Janice in them?
Yes.
All right.
All right,
everyone.
Lipstick all over my
thank you
so
me too.
Much. Have
thank
a
you, Janice.
Weekend.
I love you.
Oh, I'm
thank
so happy.
You.
Good night from Aphrodite.
Yeah.
And Athena.
And Artemis.
Who are you? And Artemis.
I love it.
Thank you so much.
Sure, everyone. Have a great Friday.
Thank you.
Super Bowl Sunday. Don't forget Minecraft.
Oh, my God.